From BBC Learning English, this is Learning English from the News, our podcast about the news headlines.
In this programme, far-right parties perform well in EU elections.
Hello, I'm Neil.
And I'm Beth.
In this podcast, we explain the vocabulary in the news headlines and how you can use it too.
You can find all the vocabulary and headlines from this episode, as well as a worksheet on our website, bbclearningenglish.com.
OK, Beth, let's talk a bit more about the story.
OK, so people in 27 different countries have voted for the politicians that they want to represent them in the European Parliament.
Yes, and the results are a little bit complicated. There's a different picture in different countries, as each country has its own parties, which then work with others from across Europe in the European Parliament.
Now, overall, the centre-right parties still have the most seats from this election.
Yes, but far-right politicians have done well in lots of countries, such as France, Germany, Italy and Austria.
Now, I have a headline here that describes this situation. This is from BBC News. Centre-right on course to strengthen majority in EU election as far-right makes gains.
So that's centre-right on course to strengthen majority in EU election as far-right makes gains.
Now, we are interested in this expression, makes gains. Neil, what can you tell us about it?
Well, gain can be used as a verb and a noun. And you might know the verb gain means to increase something or to win something. So you might, for example, gain weight, or you can gain someone's respect.
Yes. But as a noun, gain refers to the thing that you win or the increase that you make. So going back to gaining weight, the noun would be weight gain.
Yeah. Now, this expression, makes gains, is very often seen in politics, but also in the world of sports. And it's used to talk about who's winning and who's losing.
OK, so, Neil, imagine a race between you and I. If I am winning and you are behind me, but you're getting faster and closer to me, then you are making gains.
Ah, OK. Is this a running race?
It is,
and
yes.
And you're beating me?
Yeah.
OK. So the crucial thing, the really important thing to note is that with this expression, I am still not winning, but slowly the gap between us is closing.
Yes, you are making gains. Now, we often use make gains in political terms, like we have here in this headline, because big changes in political opinion and who people vote for can be a slow change. It happens over many years and even over many different elections.
Yeah, and we can also use this expression make gains to talk about progress against personal or professional challenges. So an example is that a business can make gains in its target markets.
So make gains means gradually make improvements.
So for example, I'm really making gains in my battle against the slugs in my garden. I've hardly seen any recently. This is Learning English from the News, our podcast about the news headlines. Today, we are looking at the European Union election results.
We are. So there are often quite a lot of consequences after a big election. And there is a big consequence in this story, isn't there?
Yes, there is, Beth. So the French president, Emmanuel Macron, has decided to call a national election. It's after his party performed poorly in this EU vote.
And there was also financial uncertainty. So the euro, which is the currency that's used across many countries in the EU, that's the European Union, dropped in value by 0.3% on Monday morning following the results.
Let's look at another headline then. This one is from Sky News and it is EU elections latest. Macron issues message to French voters after calling shock election. Euro slumps at uncertainty.
Okay. EU elections latest. Macron issues message to French voters after calling shock election. Euro slumps at uncertainty.
So from this headline, we're looking at the word slumps, a strange sounding word. It can be used to describe a kind of lazy way of sitting in a chair, can't it, Beth?
It can. I mean, I'm kind of slumping now. If I lean back really far in my chair quite heavily, I look quite tired.
You do look tired. You look like you're about to fall asleep.
Thanks. Yeah, so you might say that I am slumping in the chair. So it's quite a lazy thing, maybe when you have not much energy.
I guess it's usually used to describe a sort of negative situation. It's a bad thing, slumping, really.
Well, it is in that kind of instance. But we also use slump metaphorically. And again, here it's still negative, but it's to talk about a fall in the value of something. And we saw the value of the euro in the headline.
We did. It said euro slumps at uncertainty. So we're talking about the sudden drop in the value of the euro in the same way that you kind of suddenly dropped in your chair when you slumped. So we looked at slumps, falls suddenly.
And for example, we might say, I want to sell my old phone, but the prices have slumped recently, so I won't get much money for it. You're listening to Learning English from the News from BBC Learning English. And Neil and I are talking about the European election results. So, Neil, as we've heard, far-right parties won a lot of votes in some countries, like France, Austria and Germany.
But, Beth, in some countries like Sweden, Denmark and Finland, left-wing parties and green parties, those are parties who campaign about climate change, they increased their number of votes.
Now, here's another headline on this story. This is from Politico. As Europe votes, a populist wave surges.
Yeah, so again, from Politico, as Europe votes, a populist wave surges.
I think to understand this headline, we definitely need to know what populist means.
We do, and populist means someone who wants to be popular with ordinary people. But being a populist is not about a particular political viewpoint or belief. It's from both sides, isn't it?
Yeah, so this is a word that we really very often hear used in politics. In fact, we almost always hear it in politics. And we hear about politicians being left-wing or right-wing, but populists can be either or neither. It's just that idea of reflecting the opinions of everyday people.
Yeah, now looking back at this headline, it says a populist wave surges.
Yes. Now, surge, this is a verb, and it's all about movement. So a crowd can surge forward, or it could be about an increase in something. So, for example, a company's profits could surge.
Yes. And with surge, it's all about stressing that the change is strong and very quick. So in this headline, the populist wave surges. Imagine a wave moving quickly and powerfully all across the continent of Europe.
Now, obviously, this isn't a literal wave. It's metaphorical. But we do often describe ideas and political movements as waves. So we've looked at surges, which means moves or increases quickly.
And an example, support for the politician surged when she made her speech. That's it for this episode of Learning English from the News. We'll be back next week and we'll have some more news headlines and vocabulary to teach you.
And if you can't wait, then don't forget to go to our website to check out some of our other programmes. For example, Office English, which is all about the language that you need at work. Head to our website, bbclearningenglish.com.
Thanks for joining us. Bye for now.
Bye.